All right. Good evening, everybody. Sorry I'm a little bit late on the start here. Probably not a huge deal, but welcome to another week of Classic Country A to Z. This week we will continue slogging through the Johnny Cash songs. Tonight we'll cover his 1960s hits, and we'll get partway through his 1970s hits, most of them there. So there will be some more next week, more Johnny Cash again next week. But as always, always an original song in the middle and a gospel song in the end. So we'll get started right away. We got done a little early, well, on time is early, last week. Songs were short and didn't have a lot to say about a lot of them. This week probably won't be quite so early. So the first song tonight was actually the theme song to a 1959 to 1961 TV show called The Rebel. The song was written by two guys, one who did the lyrics and one who did the music. And then Johnny Cash recorded it and released it in 1961. The show and the song is all about a young Confederate soldier who sort of wandered aimlessly through the western United States right after the Civil War. This conversation, according to Johnny, was the inspiration for this song, and Johnny Yuma is the name of the song.
Away, away, away rode the rebel Johnny Yuma. Johnny Yuma was a rebel. He roamed through the west. Said Johnny Yuma, the rebel, he wandered alone. He got fighting mad, this rebel lad. He packed no star as he wandered far, where the only law was a hook and a draw. The rebel, Johnny Yuma, Johnny Yuma was a rebel. He roamed through the west. Johnny Yuma, the rebel, he wandered alone. He searched the land, this restless land. He was panther quick and leather tough, and he figured that he'd been pushed enough. The rebel, Johnny Yuma, yeah, Johnny Yuma was a rebel. He roamed through the west. Oh, Johnny Yuma, the rebel, he wandered alone. Fighting mad, this rebel lad, with a dream he'd hold to his dying breath, he'd search his soul and gamble with death. The rebel, Johnny Yuma, oh, Johnny Yuma was a rebel. He roamed through the west. Johnny Yuma, the rebel, he wandered alone. Yes, Johnny Yuma, the rebel, he wandered alone.
Okay. Who do we have? Carrie, Mary Pat. Good to see you both here. Have you with us? Next up is a song that Johnny wrote and recorded in 1961, and which became a number 11 hit for him. 26 years later, 1987, Johnny's daughter, Roseanne Cash, recorded this song and had a number one hit with it. However, when Roseanne recorded this song at her husband's suggestion, she was unaware that her father had written it and just assumed the song was in public domain. Johnny later told Roseanne that her success with this song was one of his greatest fulfillments in life. This song is called Tennessee Flat Top Box. This requires some instrumentation that's might come out a little rough. We'll see how this goes. Thank you.
in a little cabaret. In a South Texas border town sat a boy and his guitar, and the people came from all around, and all the girls from there to Austin were slipping away from home and putting jewelry in hock to take a trip to go and listen to the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play. Never cared to make a dime, but give him his guitar, and he'd be happy all the time. And all the girls from 9 to 90 were snapping fingers, tapping toes, and begging him don't stop, and hypnotized and fascinated by the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play. They forgot him in the little town, but all the girls still dreamed about him and hung around the cabaret until the doors were locked. And then one day on the hit parade was a little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play.
We struggled through it. You get the idea. I think you recognize the melody if you know the song. All right, so next one. This song was co-written by Merle Kilgore and June Carter before she married Johnny Cash, but when she was falling in love with Johnny. So June's sister Anita Carter originally recorded and released this song, but it didn't really go anywhere in the charts. So Johnny released it with the Carter sisters as backup vocals, and with a mariachi-style trumpet sound, which was new for Johnny and a little controversial for the Grand Ole Opry. It was a kind of a new introduction of horns and brass to the Grand Ole Opry. Johnny said that the trumpet sound for this song, which I'll attempt to whistle, not having a trumpet here, came to him in a dream. Johnny had a huge hit with the song as it rose to and stayed at number one for 7 weeks in 1963. It was also the title track to the only Johnny Cash album my parents had, and this song is called Ring of Fire.
Is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. Fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. The taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet. I fell for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire.
Big Hit is a song Johnny wrote and released in 1964 when it spent 6 weeks at number one on the charts for him. This was also the last song Johnny ever performed live before he passed, shortly before he passed away in 2003. And at the time, he told the audience that was the first time he'd sung the song in 25 years at that performance. This song is called Understand Your Man.
Don't call my name out your window, I'm leaving. I won't even turn my head. Don't send your kinfolk to give me no talking. I'll be gone like I said. You'd say the same old things that you've been saying all along. Lay there in your bed and keep your mouth shut till I'm gone. Don't give me that old familiar crying, fussing, moan. Understand your man, I'm tired of your bad mouthing. Understand your man. Well, you can give my other suits to the Salvation Army and everything else I leave behind. I ain't taking nothing that'll slow down my traveling while I'm untangling my mind. I ain't gonna repeat what I said anymore while I'm breathing air that ain't been breathed before. I'll be as gone as a wild goose in winter. Then you'll understand your man. Meditate on it. Understand your man. You hear me talking. Understand your man. Remember what I told you. Understand your man.
It's kind of a sassy song, I guess. All right. Well, Gail, glad to see you yet again today. And Lori and John, thanks for tuning in. Okay. Now, in 1964, Johnny released his 20th album, which was what was considered a concept album, called Bitter Tears, Ballads of the American Indian. The album focused on the history of Native Americans in the United States and their problems, and most of the songs on the album were written by folk singer Peter LaFarge. This particular song was written in honor of a Native American named Ira Hayes, who was one of the six Marine soldiers who became famous for having raised the U.S. flag on Mount Suribachi during the Battle of Iwo Jima in World War II. That's in honor of which that famous statue was created that we see with the six soldiers raising the flag. So the song has been covered by a lot of artists over the years, but Johnny's version was the most successful version when it hit number three on the charts in 1964. This largely spoken song is called The Ballad of Ira Hayes. Ira Hayes, Ira Hayes, call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian or the Marine that went to war. Gather round me, people, there's a story I would tell about a brave young Indian you should remember well. From the land of the Pima Indians, a proud and noble band who farmed the Phoenix Valley in Arizona land. Down their ditches 1,000 years, the waters grew Ira's people's crops, till the white men stole their water rights, and the sparkling water stopped. Now Ira's folks were hungry, and their land grew crops of weeds. When the war came, Ira volunteered and forgot the white man's greed. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. There they battled up Iwo Jima Hill, 250 men. But only 27 lived to walk back down again. And when the fight was over and Old Glory raised, among the men who held her high was the Indian Ira Hayes. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. Ira Hayes returned a hero, celebrated throughout the land. He was wined and speeched and honored. Everybody shook his hand. But he was just a Pima Indian. No water, no home, no chance. At home, nobody cared what Ira done, and when do the Indians dance? Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian, nor the Marine that went to war. Then Ira started drinking hard. Jail was often his home. They'd let him raise the flag and lower it like you'd throw a dog a bone. He died drunk early one morning, alone in a land he fought to save. 2 inches of water in a lonely ditch was a grave for Ira Hayes. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. Yeah, call him drunken Ira Hayes, but his land is just as dry, and his ghost is lying thirsty in the ditch where Ira died. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. Okay, now, this next song was a fiddle tune written way back in 1938 and typically played by bluegrass groups. Johnny Cash recorded in 1965 and had a number three hit with it that year, and this song is called Orange Blossom Special. This requires, for me, because I don't play the harmonica or the fiddle, requires some whistling tricks. We'll see if we get through this.
looky yonder, coming down that railroad track. Hey, looky yonder, coming down that railroad track. It's the Orange Blossom Special, bringing my baby back. Some sand in my shoes, or maybe California, and get some sand in my shoes. I'll ride that Orange Blossom Special and lose these New York blues. About her rambling, she's the fastest train on the line. Hey, talk about her traveling, she's the fastest train on the line. It's that Orange Blossom Special rolling down the seaboard line.
Might have been a little too much whistling. All right, next up, this was a number two hit for Johnny in 1965. This song was written by Jack Clement and was included on Johnny's novelty album entitled Everybody Loves a Nut. The song is a humorous criticism of musicians that put their political views into their music. And the song is called The One on the Right.
Well, there once was a musical troupe, a pickin' singin' folk group. They sang the mountain ballads and the folk songs of our land. They were long on musical ability, and folks thought they would go far. But political incompatibility led to their downfall. Well, the one on the right was on the left, and the one in the middle was on the right, and the one on the left was in the middle, and the guy in the rear was a Methodist. Well, this musical aggregation toured the entire nation, singing traditional ballads and the folk songs of our land. They performed with great virtuosity, and soon they were the rage. But political animosity prevailed upon the stage. Well, the one on the right was on the left, and the one in the middle was on the right, and the one on the left was in the middle, and the guy in the rear burned his driver's license. When the curtain had ascended, a hush fell on the crowd, as thousands there were gathered to hear the folk songs of our land. But they took their politics seriously, and that night at the concert hall, as the audience watched deliriously, they had a free-for-all. Well, the one on the right was on the bottom, and the one in the middle was on the top, and the one on the left got a broken arm, and the guy in the rear said, oh dear. Now this should be a lesson. If you plan to start a folk group, well, don't go mixing politics with the folk songs of our land. Just work on harmony and diction, and play your banjo well. And if you have political convictions, well, keep them to yourself. Now the one on the left works in a bank, and the one in the middle drives a truck. The one on the right's an all-night DJ, and the guy in the rear got drafted.
And politics with your music. All right. Next up, this was a number one hit for Johnny in 1968 that Carl Perkins actually wrote. In the song, the deep voice part was sung by Lou Reed from the Statler Brothers, one of the Statler Brothers, and the high tenor part was sung by Jan Howard, although everyone just assumed it was sung by June Carter Cash, but it wasn't. It was sung by Jan Howard. So this is Daddy Sang Bass.
I remember when I was a lad, times were hard and things were bad, but there's a silver lining behind every cloud. Just poor people, that's all we were, trying to make a living out of blackland dirt. But we'd get together in a family circle singing loud. Daddy sang bass, Mama sang tenor, me and little brother would join right in there. Singing seems to help a troubled soul. One of these days, and it won't be long, I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne. Oh, will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? When Daddy sang bass, Mama sang tenor, me and little brother would join right in there. In the sky, Lord, in the sky. I remember after work, Mama would call in all of us. Well, you could hear us singing for a country mile. Now little brother is done gone on, but I'll rejoin him in a song. We'll be together again up yonder in a little while. Well, Daddy sang bass, Mama sang tenor, me and little brother would join right in there. 'Cause singing seems to help the troubled soul. One of these days, and it won't be long, I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne. Oh, will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, Daddy sang bass, Mama sang tenor, me and little brother would join right in there. In the sky, Lord, in the sky. In the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Okay, now we've reached the point, where are we? Yeah, a little beyond halfway, I guess. We've reached the midpoint portion of the show where I do one of our original songs that my friend Charlie and I wrote. This song tonight is the first one we wrote. And this is called What She's Done Unto Others. She walked into the bar that night, two steps behind her reputation. But when her eyes met mine that night, she was preaching to the congregation. So right then and there, I offered up a prayer, please, Lord. What she's done unto others, don't let her do unto me. What she's done unto others, don't let her do unto me. My prayers are answered for a while. She became my love, my sweet salvation. But then I saw her wandering smile, giving in to another's temptations. So right then and there, I renewed my old prayer, please, Lord. What she's done unto others, don't let her do unto me. What she's done unto others, don't let her do unto me. She's an angel and a devil, and I guess I am too. But no man deserves to have his heart torn in two. She cast me out last night, back to a lonesome isolation. And to the man she's with tonight, all I can offer is cold consolation. For him and men everywhere, I offer up this prayer, please, Lord. Don't let her do unto others what she's done unto me. Don't let her do unto others what she's done unto me. Lord, don't let her do unto others what she's done unto me. All right, back to Johnny Cash. Now, next up is a song that was written by a children's author and poet, Shel Silverstein. Silverstein pitched this song to both Johnny and June, and it was June who convinced Johnny at the last minute to perform this song in his San Quentin prison concert. And so neither the filming crew nor Johnny's band even knew he was going to perform this song. And because Johnny had himself had only read through it a couple of times before the concert, he had to read the lyrics from a piece of paper when he sang it in the concert. The concert was recorded and released as an album, and this song wasn't the song everyone thought would be the hit off of this album. But nevertheless, this live recording of this song shot to number one on the country charts and number two in the pop charts in 1969. Mm-hmm. And this is called A Boy Named Sue. Okay. And I have to scroll kind of midpoint of this song because there's too many verses and lyrics to fit on one screen. So there'll be a hesitating pause in the middle. Well, my daddy left home when I was three, and he didn't leave much for Ma and me. Just this old guitar and an empty bottle of booze. And I don't blame him cause he run and hid, but the meanest thing that he ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue. Well, he must have thought it was quite a joke, and he got a lot of laughs from lots of folks. Seems I had to fight my whole life through. Well, some gal would giggle and I'd get red, some guy'd laugh and I'd bust his head. I tell you, life ain't easy for a boy named Sue. Well, I grew up quick and I grew up mean. My fists got hard and my wits got keen. Roamed from town to town to hide my shame. But I made me a vow to the moon and stars. I'd search the honky-tonks and bars and kill that man that'd give me that awful name. Well, it was Gatlinburg in mid-July and I just hit town and my throat was dry. Thought I'd stop and have myself a brew. At an old saloon in a street of mud, there at a table dealing stud sat the dirty mangy dog that named me Sue. Well, I knew that snake was my old sweet dad from a worn out picture that my mother had. I knew that scar on his cheek and his evil eye. He was big and bent and gray and old, and I looked at him and my blood ran cold, and I said, my name is Sue, how do you do? Now you're gonna die. Well, I hit him hard right between the eyes, and he went down, but to my surprise, he come up with a knife and cut off a piece of my ear. Well, I busted a chair right across his teeth, and we crashed through the wall and into the street, kicking and a-gouging in the mud and the blood and the beer. Well, I tell you, I fought tougher men, but I really can't remember when. He kicked like a mule and he bit like a crocodile. Well, I heard him laugh and then I heard him cuss, and he went for his gun, but I pulled mine first, and he stood there looking at me, and I saw him smile, and he said, son, well, this world is rough, and if a man's gonna make it, he's gotta be tough, and I knew I wouldn't be there to help you along. So I give you that name, and I said goodbye. I knew you'd have to get tough or die, and it's that name that helped to make you strong. He said, now you just fought one hell of a fight, and I know you hate me and you got the right to kill me now, and I wouldn't blame you if you do. But you gotta thank me before you die with the gavel in my guts and the spit in your eye, cause I'm the son of a gun that named you Sue. Well, what could I do? What could I do? I got all choked up and I threw down my gun. I called him a paw and he called me son, and I come away with a different point of view. And I think about him now and then, every time I try and every time I win. And if I ever have a son, I think I'm gonna name him Bill or George or Nick, anything but Sue. I still hate that name. Okay, that's kind of fun. I'm not a fan of spoken songs, but that's, I guess, kind of fun to do. Okay, now, next up, this was a number four hit for Johnny from 1969. A song he did not write. This one is called Blistered.
Great big blizzard.
blisters on my bloodshot eyes from looking at that long-legged woman up ahead. What she does simply walking down the sidewalks of that city makes me think about a stray cat getting fed. She's got a whole lot of motion in her soul, I know, but her soul ain't the place she lets it show. She got a body, oh yeah. She got emotion, oh yeah. Lord, I'm blistered, oh yeah. She done tore my soul apart, put big blisters on my heart. What a mighty, crazy, crooked way to go. Wah, 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 wah. Got great big blisters on my fingertips from reaching in my pocketbook and picking out the bills. And I got tiny white blisters in my throat from trying to ease my nervous tension taking all them happy pills. And ever since she started running around from bar to bar, I just can't eat a bite or keep my stomach settled down. She got a body, oh yeah. She got emotion, oh yeah. Lord, I'm blistered, oh yeah. She done tore my soul apart, put big blisters on my heart. What a mighty, crazy, crooked way to go. I got great big blisters on my fingertips from reaching in my pocketbook and picking out the bills. And I got tiny white blisters in my throat from trying to ease my nervous tension taking all them happy pills. And ever since she started running around from bar to bar, I just can't eat a bite or keep my stomach settled down. She got a body, oh yeah. She got emotion, oh yeah. Lord, I'm blistered, oh yeah. She done tore my soul apart, put big blisters on my heart. What a mighty, crazy, crooked way to go. Now, our next song was written by Kris Kristofferson in 1969 and was first recorded and released by Ray Stevens that year. The biggest success for the song, however, came a year later when Johnny Cash recorded it at a live performance at the Ryman Auditorium during a taping of the Johnny Cash Show. He had a TV show for a few years. And Johnny introduced this song with a monologue that ultimately got cut from the recording, but this is that monologue that Johnny gave. Quote, "You know, not everyone who's been on the bum wanted it that way. The Great Depression of the 30s set the feet of thousands of people, farmers, city workers. It set them to riding the rails. My daddy was one of those who hopped a freight train a couple of times to go and look for work. He wasn't a bum. He was a hobo, but he wasn't a bum. I suppose we've all of us, been at one time or another, drifter at heart, and today, like yesterday, there's many that are on that road heading out, not searching maybe for work as much as for self-fulfillment or understanding of their life, trying to find a meaning for their life. And they're not hopping freights much anymore. Instead, they're thumbing cars and diesel trucks along the highways from Maine to Mexico. And many who have drifted, including myself, have found themselves no closer to peace of mind than a dingy back room on some lonely Sunday morning with it coming down all around you." So, end quote. So needless to say, that monologue was cut from the recording, but once the song was released, it quickly rose to number one in the charts, and it won a CMA Song of the Year that year, 1970, and became one of Johnny Cash's signature songs. This is "Sunday Morning Coming Down." Thank you.
woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head that didn't hurt. And the beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. Then I fumbled in my closet, threw my clothes and found my cleanest dirty shirt. Then I washed my face and combed my hair and stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I'd smoked my mind the night before with cigarettes and songs I'd been picking. But I lit my first and watched a small kid playing with a can that he was kicking. Then I walked across the street and caught the Sunday smell of someone's frying chicken. And Lord, it took me back to something that I lost somewhere somehow along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. 'Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes the body feel alone. And there's nothing short of dying that's half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk and Sunday morning coming down. In the park I saw Daddy with a laughing little girl that he was swinging. And I stopped beside a Sunday school and listened to the songs they were singing. And then I headed down the street and somewhere far away a lonely bell was ringing. And it echoed through the canyons like the disappearing dreams of yesterday. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. 'Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes the body feel alone. And there's nothing short of dying that's half as lonesome as the sound of the sleeping city sidewalk and Sunday morning coming down.
Now, this next one, song Johnny wrote and released in 1970, and the song became his second-to-last number one hit. This one's called Flesh and Blood.
Beside a singing mountain stream where the willow grew, where the silver leaf of maple sparkled in the morning dew. I braided twigs of willows, made a string of buckeye beads, but flesh and blood need flesh and blood, and you're the one I need. Yes, flesh and blood need flesh and blood, and you're the one I need. Well, I leaned against a bark of birch and I breathed the honeydew. I saw a northbound flock of geese against a sky of baby blue. Beside the lily pads I carved a whistle from a reed. Mother Nature's quiet lady, but you're the one I need. Flesh and blood need flesh and blood, and you're the one I need. A cardinal sang just for me, and I thanked him for the song. Then the sun went slowly down the west, and I had to move along. These were some of the things on which my mind and spirit feed. But flesh and blood need flesh and blood, and you're the one I need. Yeah, flesh and blood need flesh and blood, and you're the one I need. So when this day was ended, I was still not satisfied, for I knew everything I touched would wither and would die. And love is all that will remain and grow from all these seeds. Mother Nature's quiet lady, but you're the one I need. Yes, flesh and blood need flesh and blood, and you're the one I need. Oh, flesh and blood need flesh and blood, and you're the one I need.
Okay, so now Johnny wrote, recorded, and released this next song in 1971. It's a protest song, protesting against the treatment of poor people by wealthy politicians, protesting against mass incarceration, protesting against the war in Vietnam. It's a protest song, covers lots of topics. In the intro to his very first performance of the song, he revealed that he had talked to some of the audience members from Vanderbilt University that weekend and was inspired to write the song, revising it a few times just before the concert. So he performed the song using note cards with the just revised lyrics, and at the end of the song he received a standing ovation. The song rose to number 3 in the charts for him and became another signature song for him. This song is called Man in Black.
Well, you wonder why I always dress in black, why you never see bright colors on my back, and why does my appearance seem to have a somber tone? Well, there's a reason for the things that I have on. I wear the black for the poor and beaten down, living in the hopeless, hungry side of town. I wear it for the prisoner who has long paid for his crime, but he's there 'cause he's a victim of the times. I wear the black for those who've never read or listened to the words that Jesus said about the road to happiness through love and charity. Why, you'd think he's talking straight to you and me. Well, we're doing mighty fine, I do suppose, in our streak of lightning cars and fancy clothes. But just so we're reminded of the ones who are held back, up front there ought to be a man in black. I wear it for the sick and lonely old, for the reckless ones whose bad trip left them cold. I wear the black in mourning for the lives that could have been. Each week we lose 100 fine young men. And I wear it for the thousands who have died, believing that the Lord was on their side. I wear it for another 100,000 who have died, believing that we all were on their side. Well, there's things that never will be right, I know, and things need changing everywhere you go. But till we start to make a move to make a few things right, you'll never see me wear a suit of white. Oh, I'd love to wear a rainbow every day and tell the world that everything's okay. But I'll try to carry off a little darkness on my back till things are brighter. I'm the man in black.
Now, this next song was actually written by Marty Robbins, who we will get to when we get to the M's. Johnny recorded and released it in 1972. It went to number 2 on the charts for him. And it's called Kate.
I saw you with another, it made me lose my mind. Shot you with my 38, and now I'm doing time. And you put me here, you put me here. Well, there's no need to doubt it, there ain't no two ways about it. As sure as your name's Kate, you put me here. I've been trying to tell them that I didn't do no wrong, only gave you what you've been deserving all along. And you put me here, you put me here. Well, there ain't no use denying, you've done it with your lying. As sure as your name's Kate, you put me here. Well, the jury found me guilty, they wouldn't hear my plea. I listened as that judge said murder in the first degree. And you put me here, you put me here. Well, there's no need to doubt it, there ain't no two ways about it. As sure as your name's Kate, you put me here. Well, the warden and the preacher, they're letting me go slow. It won't be long until I'm gone, just 13 steps to go. And you put me here, you put me here. There's just one way to figure, you're cheating, pull the trigger. And sure as your name's Kate, you put me here. No, there's no need to doubt it, there ain't no two ways about it. As sure as your name's Kate, you put me here. You put me here. You put me here.
Okay, we'll leave the murder song. I told Charlie when we wrote ours, there's always a lot of murder songs in country music. Okay, next up's another 1972 hit. Another 1972 number 2 hit for Johnny. This one he did not write, but his interpretation of the song sure made it seem like he wrote it. This song is one of several of Johnny's songs that pay tribute to the working man, and this one's called Oney. If you've ever had a bad boss in a job, this song was written for that, I think. Well, I dedicate this song to the working man, for every man who puts in hard 8 or 10 hours a day of work and toil and sweat. Always got somebody looking down his neck, trying to get more out of him than he really ought to have to put in. After 29 long years of working in this shop with Oney standing over me,
Today when that old whistle blows, I'll check in all my gear and I'll retire. The superintendent just stopped by and said they planned my little get-together. And then he said I'd never made it if old Oney hadn't held me to the fire. Well, I've seen him in my dreams at night and woke up in the morning feeling tired. And old Oney don't remember when I came here how he tried to get me fired. With his folded hands behind him every morning, Oney waited at the gate, where he'd rant and rave like I committed murder, clocking in 5 minutes late. But today they'll gather round me like I've seen them do when any man retires. And old Oney's gonna tell me from now on I'm free to do what I desire. He'll present me with that little gold watch they give a man at times like this. But there's one thing he's not counting on. Today's the day I give old Oney his. I've been working, building muscles. Oney's just been standing around and getting soft. And today about 4:30 I'll make up for every good night's sleep I've lost. When I'm gone, I'll be remembered as the working man that put his point across. With a right hand full of knuckles, 'cause today I show old Oney who's the boss. Yeah, with a right hand full of knuckles, 'cause today I show old Oney who's the boss.
Now, our next one, holy smokes, we are over. We have one more Johnny Cash, and then our gospel song. Okay, the next one. It's a title track to Johnny's 44th album from 1972, entitled Any Old Wind That Blows. The song was the third single released off that album, and the song rose to number 3 on the charts in 1972, and so the song is called Any Old Wind That Blows.
Lord, she's restless, like cotton candy clouds that sail the day, slow and free. She possesses a mind that can't resign itself to stay for long with me. So I tried and tried to keep her tied and satisfied until she really needs me. Yes, I do. But when that certain look comes on her face, I can't replace it, and she leaves me. She's a butterfly in mid-July who just can't wait to try her brand new wings on brand new things. And she needs no rhyme or reason when she goes. Her mind is on what lies beyond that wall of blue horizon, I suppose. And heaven knows she'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. Yes, she will. Yes, she will. She'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. I know she needs me about as much as I need someone else, which I don't. And if need be, I swear someday I'll up and leave myself, which I won't. Even if she loved another man, I'd understand it more than I do. Mm-hmm. But I know the only reason that she ever has for leaving is she wants to. Yeah, she's a butterfly in mid-July who just can't wait to try her brand new wings on brand new things. And she needs no rhyme or reason when she goes. Her mind is on what lies beyond that wall of blue horizon, I suppose. And heaven knows she'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. Yes, she will. Yes, she will. She'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows.
All right. That takes us to our gospel song. This was written by William Golden in 1918 while he was serving an 8-year sentence in the Mississippi State Penitentiary. This was called A Beautiful Life.
Each day I'll do a golden deed by helping those who are in need. My life on earth is but a span, and so I'll do the best I can. Life's evening sun is sinking low. A few more days and I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, where there will be no setting sun. While going down life's weary road, I'll try to lift some traveler's load. I'll try to turn the night to day, make flowers bloom along the way. Be a child of God each day. My light must shine along the way. I'll sing his praise while the angels roam, and strive to help some troubled soul. Life's evening sun is sinking low. A few more days and I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, where there will be no setting sun. Well, the only life that will endure is one that's kind and good and pure. And for God, I'll take my stand. Each day I'll lend a helping hand. Life's evening sun is sinking low. A few more days and I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, where there will be no setting sun. Where there will be no setting sun.
which takes us to our benediction.
May the good Lord bless and keep you, whether near or far away. May you find that long-awaited golden day today. May your troubles all be small ones, and your fortune 10 times 10. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May you walk with sunlight shining and a bluebird in every tree. May there be a silver lining back of every cloud you see. Fill your dreams with sweet tomorrows, never mind what might have been. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May you walk with sunlight shining and a bluebird in every tree. May there be a silver lining back of every cloud you see. Fill your dreams with sweet tomorrows, never mind what might have been. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet, till we meet again.
All right. Well, that wraps us up for this week. Thank you for tuning in and for watching. Have a great week. Have a safe week. We will be back again next Sunday at 7 o'clock Central. With more Johnny Cash. I don't know if we'll finish Johnny Cash next week. I think we might, but I'm not positive. Anyway, have a great week, and we will see you next Sunday. Good night, everybody.